I don't want to be a guinea pig. Maybe one of the first things that goes through a person's head when asked to become a research volunteer. If so, maybe it's because research with human subjects has such a complex history and is surrounded by so many myths. Without denying the past, it's important to know how far we've come about the right way to do research and about the laws that now exist to ensure that people are protected. Knowing this can help put your mind at ease. Before human volunteers are ever involved, researchers collect as much information as possible about what is being studied. For example, they will usually review all existing health records and research all new ideas in a lab using cells or animals. Researchers will then design their studies based on all of the information they find. This helps provide maximum protection for those who volunteer. Research volunteers have added protection because all studies are required to undergo an independent review before they can start. The name of the committee that performs this review is the Institutional Review Board, or IRB. Usually, each university or hospital has its own IRB that review research that happens there. IRBs include scientists who are knowledgeable on the topic being studied, experts in ethics, and members of the local community. The IRB reviews all known risks to participating in the study and checks to see how volunteers will be protected. IRBs ensure that all studies have a plan to fully inform volunteers and get their informed consent. This consent includes all meaningful information about the risks involved that a person would need to know to make an informed choice about whether or not to enroll in a study. A researcher can only begin a study after it has the approval of an IRB. There may also be a separate experimental subjects bill of rights that lists all rights of any study volunteer. All of these protections work together to ensure that research subjects are never guinea pigs.